Five, four.
Color Gaming with another Commander Deck Tech. And today we are going to talk about the Upside Down. Oh, sorry. Stranger Things. Nope. Dang it. I mean, Yarrok. Yeah, that guy. We all know it's that one of those things from Stranger Things, right? I mean, it's a Demigorgon. Look at it. It's a Demigorgon. But this Demigorgon, brought to you by Wizard of the Coast, likes to double ETB effects. And you're in Sultai. How many things in Sultai could there be? And is it even worth it to make a Yarrok ETB deck with these? I mean, come on. There can't be anything possibly good. And yeah, there's lots of things good. I mean, there's just so many good things. So without further ado, what we'll do is we'll go into the deck tech. I'll go over land base, enchantments, instant sorceries, creatures, artifacts, everything you need to have your own little Yarrok build of double awesomeness, dare I say. No, I can't say that? Oh. Of double cool? No, I should stop. Okay, I've been told that I should just stop and we're just going to jump right into it. So without further ado, let's get started. All right. So first off, we're going to talk about Yarrok. We got to talk about the creatures. Now, some good ETB creatures to have. So we've got Reclamation Sage. So when it comes into play, you get to destroy a target artifact or enchantment. But with Yarrok, you do it twice. So always a good hit. Now, I like this guy, Royal Elemental. There is a sub-landfall theme in this deck, as you'll see. We have a couple of go get multiple lands out because, I mean, you're in the best ramp colors right now that there are, so why not make use of it? So Royal Elemental says, whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, you may gain control of target creature as long as Royal Elemental survives. So, land enters the battlefield. Well, that's landfall trigger. That's an ETB. So I'm going to gain two things. Another land, two things. Another land, two things. You see where I'm going with this. Balefill Strix. Oh my god, just the value. Two Flying Death Touch, draw two cards with him on the battlefield. If not, two for a Flying Death Touch that just draws a card. Can't say enough good things about that value. Acidic Slime. Now, I know everyone does not like land destruction. I hate land destruction, but it's pretty funny sometimes. I mean, you know, if there's a Cabal Coffers or a Yawgmoth and it's just going off, I mean, this guy right here. I'm just saying, he gives you that option. It is or land, so they did tail it towards the end of it because they want you to look at the artifact or enchantment. But land is in there. Just saying. And we are playing Sultai, so reanimation? Maybe. Let's see here. What else do we got? So Uro, speaking from the new set, this is just a great card. Gain 6 life, draw 2 cards, put 2 lands into play. Again, triggering off a sub-landfall theme with this deck is just good. I mean, if he's on the battlefield, everything you play from there on out is just added value with double triggers. So when you start building Yarrok, you know, make sure that the creatures you have great value to begin with, but can get you more value with Yarrok out. And you start seeing there's a lot of things that can happen. Like, what else? You know, it's just a common, but whenever one of enters the battlefield, search the library for a forest card. So not basic forest, no, forest card. So that's your dual land, your as soon to be upcoming triomes that have forest in them. You could go get one of those, or if he's out, go get two of them. Good land ramp, very good land ramp. Coiling Oracle. Now, when Coiling Oracle enters the battlefield, reveal the top card of your library. If it's a land, it comes directly to the battlefield, otherwise it goes to your hand. So card draw plus landfall triggers. You see where we're going through. Synergy is very important in this deck. If your cards work together, especially with Yarrok on the battlefield, four creatures, double land drops, I mean, it just works. Now, I will show you one card. I love this card. Gilded Drake, one of my favorite cards from back in the Urza set. You do get a double ETB trigger, but only one of them resolves. So if you wanted to be like, oh, I'm going to grab that creature here and that creature. No. Because of this wording of the second phrase, that this has to either be sacrificed or you get that. It's an either or thing. Just choose one creature for both targets and you'll usually get the creature, or they'll sacrifice it and you sack that and get it back and do it again. Either way, it's just good value. Two, and like, oh, I'm going to take that Eldrazi and you can have a 3-3, then kill the 3-3 and keep on doing it. Very fun. Very fun. Of course, you cannot have a Soul Tide deck without E-Witness, what we're talking about. Recursion, the ability to get stuff back from the graveyard. Double triggers with Yarrok, get two things back from the graveyard. Mwah! So good. Love everything about it. Solemn actually pulls double duty with Yarrok on the battlefield. It gets you two basic lands from your deck tapped. I mean, that's just always good. You don't get double die triggers because that's not an ETB. That is a leave the battlefield effect. But so good. We have Vincer, the Shaper Savant. Ooh, now this can be very good in many ways. If somebody goes to attack, you can go ahead, flash this out, bounce two things, or return a spell to somebody's hand and bounce something, or maybe even counter an entire stack. If somebody's doing a counter war and you don't want anything resolved, well, I'll bounce that to your hand and bounce that to your hand. Nothing resolves. So Vincer, the Shaper Savant, very good, especially if you get to start doubling triggers, but just good in and of itself. We have the Grave Titan. Now, Grave Titan, oh my goodness. With Yarrok on the battlefield, I mean, it makes four tokens, which is great. And then every time you attack, you make two. But we have a couple things in this deck that allows you to keep on bouncing and bouncing and bouncing and bouncing. So he can be an army unto himself, just making you 4, 8, 16 zombies. It's just so good. Plus 6 for 6/6 with Death Touch. I mean, the value train does not stop there. Speaking of the value train, let's talk about the Avenger of Zendikar. Oh my goodness, double ETBs on the stack, please. So when it enters the battlefield, you're not only going to get a bunch of 0/1s, right? They're just going to be, okay, well, I have 16 lands. Well, now you got 32 creatures, thanks to Yarrok. But whenever a land hits the battlefield, this triggers, which is this triggering. So your creatures are going to get 2 +1/+1 counters for every land that comes into play. That, my friend, is some good, good value. Hostage Taker. Oh, yeah, I'm just going to steal two things and play them and laugh. Most of the time it happens, unless you target a Sensei's Divining Top, which I never do. There was that one time. I don't want to talk about it. Anyway, so we get two things, especially with Yarrok out. If not, one thing is always good. Mole Drifter. Oh, so good. So, 3. Draw 2 cards anyway, if you evoke them. But 3 to draw 4 with Yarrok out. Ooh, so good. We also got a Chaomancer, because we want to make sure we can get some of our instants and sorceries out of our graveyard. And when I start showing them to you, you're going to understand why we want some of those instants and sorceries back from our graveyard once we cast them. Because one time cast is never enough, my friend. You got to have double the casting. I still can't do that. Why can't I do that? No, I know it's a double joke, but they'll get it. Oh, they're going to be tired of it? Oh. I was just told that maybe I should lay off the double jokes. So I was told doubly. you see what I did? I should stop. Okay, moving on. So next on our list, we have Ravenous Chupacabra. That nice little uncommon from Ixalan many a moon ago. When it enters the battlefield, destroy target creature and opponent controls. Well, I mean, 4 for doing that's pretty good anyway. But with Yarrok out, just blast 2 of them. Oh, that is some of that sweet, sweet value we are talking about. Speaking of sweet, sweet value, let's talk about some more ramp. When the Spring Bloom Druid, Spring Bloom Druid enters the battlefield, you may sacrifice land. If you do, search your library for up to 2 basic land cards and put them onto the battlefield. Well, I think that's pretty good. I'll sacrifice 2 lands and get 4. I think that works. Yes. Land and ramp and Simic go together quite well. Let's talk about Let's talk about this guy. So when he enters the battlefield, you get to take 1 creature from each opponent's graveyard and put it onto the battlefield. Well, with our boy out there, That could be 2, 4, 6 creatures coming onto your side of the battlefield with more ETBs, with more shenanigans. Oh, value train does not stop for this, I swear. And then I put him in here. We all know he was going to be here. It's Sultai. If you guys haven't seen this enough in Standard already, then you haven't been playing a lot of games in Standard, because right now, with all the Ikora stuff that's coming out, oh my god, Winota decks use him, Blink decks, it just goes on and on, but you get the point. I'm going to steal a permanent. Now I'm going to steal 2 permanents. When I get up to 3 permanents, I start drawing cards. Again, the value train is so good not to put in there. So good. We also have a Rune Scar Demon, which is basically 2 Diabolic Tutors on a Steak. So, I mean, 6, 7, 4 for a D tutor is usually, well, late game it's fine. You still want to get what you want, but when you have both those out there to get 2 of them, oh, so good, so satisfying. And now we talk about this guy. Yeah, there's a Deadeye Navigator in this deck. What can we do with Deadeye Navigator, people? Well, let's just, I'm going to move him here. I'm going to Soul Bond that right there. And then for 2 mana with 1 blue and 1 generic, you could just keep on doing that until your friends walk out and you never play with them again. I'm so lonely. Anyway, moving on. So Soul, Deadeye, Navigator, and Agent of Treachery. Whew, yeah. And, whoa. But our last but not least big guy for doubling is Craterhoof Behemoth. Because once you start stealing everything or resurrecting everything on your side of the battlefield, oh my goodness, why not just finish everyone's utter misery and just keep on making them monstrous to the point where, yeah, you're just going to wipe out the table. It's so good. But with all the ETB creatures out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about some of our good value creatures. So, Consecrate Sphinx. Who doesn't like drawing cards? I want to draw the cards. I want to draw like all the cards. There's never enough card draw until you actually don't have cards to draw. Which, by the way, there is no Lab Man or Thassa's Oracle in this deck, so that can kill you. I might have had it happen to me. Because I like cards. Don't judge me. Even if you are judging me, still don't. We have a Nyx Bloom Ancient, because that card in any situation is so good. So good. And then when you... Oh god, it's just good. I have no follow-ups to that. It's just... It's so good. So much mana to do so many broken things that you will see of in our instants and sorceries. Mainly our sorceries coming up. We also have a Tatiova, because we like drawing 2 cards and gaining 2 life for every land that comes into play. Who wouldn't? Birds of Paradise, early ramp, early value, early blocker, early death. Yeah, it's just... It's good early game. And late game, depending on what's coming at you. Like, it can still block a dragon. As long as the dragon doesn't have trample. So, boop, block. Bloom Tender. We like mana. We like all the mana. If you couldn't tell already, mana is our friend. Bloom Tender out, especially with reanimating everything on the board. You have a chance for this to bring you 5 mana just by a turn. So, that could add up quite a bit. We also have a Kozilek. Now, this is in here for twofold. Getting into the habit of putting at least 1 of the Eldrazi's in my deck, just for the simple fact of whenever it's milled or goes into the graveyard, I just shuffle my entire graveyard back into my library and keep on going. Not that I don't have friends with mill decks. You know who I'm talking about. Uh-huh. Yeah, you. Uh-huh. It's for you. You know it is. Anyway, our last one, because we do like Blink and like getting multiple ETB value, is Thassa Deep Dwelling. Because, as I said, if you're not seeing these 2 in Standard, you are the luckiest person ever, because you're not playing the most broken decks in Standard right now. But just to be able to blink, 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 so many good things is, oh, so good, so juicy. So, with creatures out of the way, let's double shift. Okay, I'll stop. God. Jeez, my producer just like over there just so doubly mad at me. Oh god, put it down. Oh my god. only a quick drive back from the hospital just to continue on with our deck tech, going on with enchantments. So, let's start off with Rhystic Study. If you're playing blue, Rhystic Study is almost a must. Again, we don't have any ways to win from drawing out our entire deck, but early game card draw, get what you need, is never a bad thing. Speaking of early game card draw, we drop that Mystic Remora. Now, you do have that cumulative upkeep, but in theory, you know, play this on turn one, you're going to be paying it for maybe a couple turns because no one's going to be able to pay four to actually stop you from drawing cards. It's just not going to happen. So card draw, early game, set up your hands, set up your combo. Cannot say enough good things about these good cards. But we also like to scry a little bit, and to scry in green, let's go ahead and do a Sylvan Library. Now usually Sylvan Library says, draw your first card, look at the top two, and if you want, you can take them by paying, I believe it's 4 extra life per card. But we all know it says that just draw 3, pay 8 life. I mean, come on. It's draw 3, pay 8 life. You know it is. I know you know what it is. Let's see. Speaking of card draw, Guardian Project. As I said before in my Almanath video, if you're running green, you run Guardian Project. It has to be one of the cards in the 99. Or at least on the table to be talked about as one of the cards in the 99, because every creature you play is going to be different. Therefore, you're going to be getting card draw. Cannot overestimate the value of this card, especially if you can play it in green. Now, one of my other very fun cards to play is called Treachery. Now, Treachery has an interesting wording on it. So, Treachery says, when Treachery comes into play, which is an ETB, untap 5 lands and you control enchanted creature. So, what Treachery really says is that if you have 10 lands on the battlefield, it's going to cost you 5 to do this, right? And you're going to take control of something. Well, why don't you go ahead and tap out, right? So you have 5 floating plus the 5 to play this. When this comes into play, you're going to untap all 10 lands, netting you 5 mana. So you can cast something for 15 or start replaying him, or, oh my goodness, that is just value enchantment on a stick. But to go with our inevitable hate of people trying to kill everything we've got, we have Phyrexian Reclamation. Now, we do have a few things in here that gain us life. So, paying 2 life to bring something back, life's a resource. Why not just go ahead, pay 2 life, maybe let him go to the graveyard, pay 2 life, get it back, kind of forego the commander tax. It's fantastic ability. And, you know, we like reanimation, so why not just reanimate dead? On anything. I don't care if it comes back with a -1, -0. Oh, look, you've left your insert big name here of creature in your graveyard. Then I'm just going to take it and hopefully get an ETB off of it. Or maybe I'll just get back Yarrok because I don't feel like paying the 2 life or the commander tax. Very, very useful card. I cannot say enough about it. So from enchantments, let's go ahead and go into artifacts. So, basic ramp package with artifacts. If you're in green, you can play the Great Henge, which is gain you life, negate hopefully what you paid for Phyrexian Reclamation, put a +1 counter, draw a card. As you said, card draw cannot be understated enough in Commander. You have 99 other cards to get to. So, ways to draw cards and filter through your deck cannot be overlooked. We also have Soul Ring. Pretty art Soul Ring, or any type of Soul Ring you want. It's always good. We also have Mana Vault, just because 1 for 3, early game him, or, I mean, turn 2 or even turn 1 that, depending on what else you get. We also have a Mana Crypt, because I don't think I have a deck now that doesn't have a Mana Crypt. Especially with Mystery Boosters coming out, there's a decent chance to actually get one, so if you're lucky enough to have one, put it in a deck. I don't think there's any real deck that should not play it. The Lightning Bolt yourself for 3 kind of hurts. I've died to that more than once, but still, turn 0 or turn 1 to have 2 free mana, last resource. Have fun with it. Felwar Stone, just to make sure we get our mana colors. I mean, this, into a land, that means you have 5 land by turn 2. So, yay. And then we got some good old value artifacts. Now, panharmonicon. Oh, yeah. So we want double and double. Oh, the joy it will bring to people when they see it, because they know it's coming, and if they have no responses or no answers, oh, so good. And then we got Conjurer's Closet, because one thought is not enough. We need to be able to go blink, blink, double, double, blink, blink, double, 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 blink, blink, double. Hey, producer, double the trouble. Concussions in the same day is perfectly fine. As my producer tells me, memory skip. Anyway, moving on to our rant package for Yarrok. Since we're in green, let's go ahead and talk about awesome green spells. Go get land. So, Nature's Lore, go get a forest card. Now listen, it says forest card, so any duels, any tries that actually have forest in, anything that has a forest in the name of the card, you're good, because it's a forest card. Such a good card. 2 mana, go get anything. So good. Farseek. Well, we don't really have plains, but we do have islands and swamps. Don't really have mountains, but who cares? Islands or swamps. And since because of that, as I said, all of our duels that you'll see here in a second, the Shocklands, the Triomes, can all be gotten by Farseek. Of course, we have Rampant Growth. We have Cultivate, as I said. Green lends itself so well to being able to get to your ramp and get to your mana quicker. So if we have one of our landfall triggers, so we have Avenger of Zendikar, we have Tatiova. I mean, just being able to draw cards, gain life, draw cards, gain life, draw cards, gain life. It adds up so well. But thankfully in sorceries, we do have answers to other people's shenanigans as well. So we do have a nice little board wipe plan. So Torment of Hellfire. Now, you see with all the ramp we can get, especially the ramp off the creatures, we can go get a massive mana base. And with our legendary elemental swamp thing guy, yes, I forgot his name, and I'm making up stuff because I forgot his name. 2 concussions, man. I don't want to hear it. We can make a Torment of Hellfire for in the hundreds. So, always fun to see that actually resolve and just look at the despair in everyone's faces. And then as they walk away from your table, you start to cry because you're so lonely. yes, destruction. Anyway, moving on. Decree of Pain. I love this card. It's very high costed. Granted, you can do it for 5 and cycle a bunch of 1/1s. So if somebody plays a token deck, -2/-2 is pretty good. But the ability to draw cards from everything you destroy is just a board wipe plus awesome. So cannot say enough good things about the card. Plus, we have enough ramp with this, our creatures, to where this actually is, it might be 7, but we can play it a lot earlier. Of course, we got to put a Damnation in there just as a, oh my god, you're doing too much over there. You already have 727 elves. Yeah, no, go away. Just has to be in there. Victimize, as far as our reanimation package goes, is a very good card. It is a 1/2. So we have that Birds of Paradise on the battlefield, but we have 2 just absolute destructive things in the graveyard. Let's say it's our mana tripler, and maybe the Primordial, that guy. We can sacrifice our birds to get back both those creatures to the battlefield, re-trigger the ETBs. Oh, Victimize. Such a good card. Highly recommend picking one up. And of course, you can't have... You can't be playing black without at least 1 D-Tutor. So the ability to get anything out of your deck cannot be understated. Especially in that right time to where you need something. Hint. Go get it, play it, and say, oh my goodness, I survived for 1 more turn. Can I make it to the other one? And now, the main reason for all this ramp and Yarrok, and why I originally wanted to build the deck in the first place. Villainous Wealth. Now, Villainous Wealth states that target opponent exiles the top X cards of his or her library. You may cast any number of non-land cards from among them without paying their mana cost as long as it's X or less. So it's Sultai and X. So we can make a lot of mana. A lot of mana. And that could be our finisher. So I have Villainous Well Somebody for 60, and it was absolutely fantastic. Then you Archaeomancer, get it back, untap all your stuff, do it again. It's so good. I highly recommend this card. This is, when I saw Yarrok, that was actually the first thing I thought about when building this deck, was I want to build Villainous Wealth with so much ramp and extra packages. But I love Villainous Wealth, and this is just a perfect home for it. So, with sorceries out of the way, let's get right into instants. So, with our instant package, I know you were like, oh my goodness, he's probably playing counter dot deck, right? Like, it's just nothing but counter spells, and you're not going to let people play. Well, you're not 100% right. Maybe like 80%? 85 tops? Yes, counter spells. I mean, you're in the right colors for it. We're trying to do a lot of degenerate things. And people are not going to want those things to happen. So we need to find ways to protect them. So Mystic Confluence is actually a counterspell plus. Way more. I mean, counterspell, return something to its hand, draw a card. But you get to choose three. And you get to choose the same more, than once. So late game, if you're stuck, can't find anything, well, maybe draw three cards before it becomes your turn. Or counterspell, 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 just negate the entire stack. I mean, Mystic Confluence has so much value. Of course, we have good old counterspell, because it's counterspell. Counter target spell. Yeah, I have nothing else for that one. Mana Drain. Oh, I love me some Mana Drain. For two mana, it can absolutely make or break. Especially the plan we have in this. We have a lot of high-costed stuff in this deck. Granted, we have the ramp to do it, but sometimes we need a little extra help. So our friends, our wonderful, wonderful friends, like to give us mana. Even though it's colorless mana, you know what? They're awesome, especially if they want to torment a Hellfire for like 15 and we just counter it and we just get it all. So, sometimes your friends really like helping you, and then they don't like helping you because you played that. We also got Arcane Denial. It's a nice little counterspell. Hey, you know what? You draw two, I'll draw one. So, it's counterspell with card draw. Yes, you're giving them two cards, but if you're saving your creatures, then totally worth it. It's so low-costed. Plus, we're playing three colors, so our ability to have one blue and something else is a lot better than having two of the same color, so it helps a lot. We also got Swan Song because, hey, I want to counter this. Okay, well, I'm going to give you a bird. I know how it sounded. Stop thinking that way. So counter a enchantment or instant or sorcery, and they get a bird. So this can be a one mana I saved your life type card. Very good card, especially for this deck. And sometimes we want to play what they play. I mean, if we're playing another Sultai deck and somebody Villainous Wells us, well, maybe we can turn back around them. Or maybe we can return their Torment of Hellfire. Or return something absolutely nasty. Say, okay, well, I'm going to draw X amount of cards. You know what? I'd like to draw cards. Narset Reversal is a fantastic card. You just have to be aware that it gets bounced to their hand and they will play it again. But we might have something for it. Or maybe you buy everyone an extra turn to where they can have answers for it. Very good card. Of course, you know, sometimes we just don't like people to have things. So we return them all to their hand and be like, you know what? Your hand is empty. I want to help you with that. I want to give you all your cards back. In essence, I'm playing group hug. I'm seeing how many of people believe that. No one? Oh, I try. So what else we have? We have more ramp. So crop rotation, sacrifice the land, search your library for a land card, and put that. So this is a very, very good card, especially if you're missing a key color for one mana. Okay, I have blue. I have blue galore, people. I don't need more blue. I'm going to sacrifice an island. I'm going to go get a land card of my choice. Now, one other good thing about this is it's just land card. So Cabal Coffers, Yawgmoth, Stronghold, I mean, anything. It is go get a land and put it into the battlefield is so good, especially at instant speed. Cannot be overstated enough that that's just a very good card. Shared summons. And Commander, if you're playing green, another good card to think about because it lets you just go get any two creatures from your deck, put them into your hand. Granted, everyone knows what you're getting, but, you know, you have this, so hopefully your value can just outweigh them. Don't go, like, I'm going to go get Craterhoof Behemoth. You'll never play another card, because now they know you have Craterhoof Behemoth, and you're going to go just start drawing all kinds of ire. Although, if you have your mana tripler out and all the mana in the world, yeah, go get Craterhoof Behemoth and just play it, because it's funny. No one believes that as well? Okay, moving on to the last card. Assassin's Trophy. I like the ability to destroy permanents. How many times have you been in a game to where it was not a creature or an artifact? Maybe it was an enchantment. Maybe it was something else. Maybe a land. Maybe somebody has a tabernacle. Something on the battlefield you just can't get rid of. Assassin's Trophy, thankfully, just says destroy a target permanent and opponent control. So, yeah. Just anything. Like, oh my god, get away here. Stop cursing me and let me live my life. You know? So, with that being said, that is our instant package. We will go into our mana base next. So, finally, let's talk about Yarrok land base. Now, we play 35 lands, which is, you know, a little short. I usually like to play 36, 37, but we have a lot of ramp. We have a lot of ways to go get the lands we need to hopefully cast what we need at any given point in time. So, 35, I think, is quite reasonable for this deck. As you can see, we actually have the amount of lands we can search. So that's using Misty, Rainforest, Verdant Catacombs, Polluted Delta, Prismatic Vista, Flood to Strand, and our other things are the creatures to go get actual cards we need. This is our current, what we can go search for. As I said, dual lands help because I like Tropical Island. It is a forest island. Even though it doesn't say it, it got errated to it. The Shock Lands help a lot. Now, this is a great card. I actually did not realize this until I was, you know, doing some early deck building and taking Yarrok apart, putting it back together. But Mystic Sanctuary is actually a very searchable card because it is an island. And that helps you get back, what does that say? Yeah, instant or sorcery from your graveyard to the top of your library. Yeah, I could definitely see that happening. I mean, if you wanted to Villainous Wealth somebody, you cast it, you get everything. Okay, I'll play a Flood Strand, crack it, Mystic, get that on top, my turn. Uh-oh, stuff has just happened. So I separated these, this is what we got here. So this is all of the things we can search for. This is basically value lands. So Bajookabog, just exile a graveyard, Ghost Quarter, hopefully get rid of probably like a Cabal Coffers like we have over here, or some other shenaniganery that opponent has, a strip mine. Yeah, go score for strip mine. It's kind of a one for one, but, you know, Maze of Ith is another good one. Some, you know, some of our things would like to attack, and we don't want that to happen, or they don't want that to happen. Oh my god, concussions are back. As you can see, we also have our Cabal Coffers Urborg package. Yes, I can't say Urborg because I don't know why. Hey, I just said it. Hey, confetti. So, Cabal Coffers, Urborg, turn everything to a swamp, double all that black mana. Oh, just so good. And if you ever really want to have fun, have the mana tripler out and tap Cabal Coffers. And, yeah, that's a fun day right there. Woohoo! Wreck Tower, Ancient Tomb, as said, value lands. We want to make sure that if we do draw a bunch of cards, we can keep them all. Ancient Tomb, early, two free mana, shocks you for two, we can deal with it. River Tears, Dark Slick Shore, Woodland, Cemetery, Underground River, Botanical Sanctum, Nurturing Peatland, Land War Waste, Waterlogged Grove, and Temple of Malady. Basically, color fixing. So, these lands cannot be searched, but they fix our colors. Like blue, we got black, green, we got green, blue. Some of them you have to pay a life for, but whatever, life's a resource. And then over here, three lands that basically tap for anything. If I'm running any more than one color, I usually have these three lands in a deck, just because it doesn't make sense not to. Your opponents are usually going to play something in your color wheel. If not, I mean, you can make it work. And to pay one life to get any mana you need at any given point in time, as I said, life's a resource. There's ways to gain life in this deck. Not that big a deal. So, now we talked about creatures, we talked about instants and sorceries, we went through our artifacts, our enchantments, our land base. Whew, I think it's time for the wrap-up. Mystical Fade. So, everyone, that is my Yarrok the Desecrated deck, or the upside-down Stranger Thing creature thing that blanks, does double things. I said double in reference. I did not do a double joke. Stay over there. Okay. So I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, please like the video, subscribe to it for more content. We have more deck techs coming up, some arena coming up in the near future, some Commander 2020 reviews, which should be very fun, as well as some upgrades you can do for them. So until then, thank you so much for watching. Have yourself a great day, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Farewell.